Is he taking pictures?
It's a video chat. Inspector's on the camera.
No, I'm saying him. That's what I'm saying. What are you guys going to take pictures of?
The inside of the rooms.
Of my personal stuff is what I'm saying. No.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Leveraging Real Estate for Freedom. So this episode, we just closed on a duplex. We call this the blue house. As you can see, it's very blue. That's the blue house, okay? It's upstairs, downstairs, both upstairs and downstairs. It's 4-bedroom, 1-bathroom each. It's a duplex, so it's 8 bedrooms and 2 bathrooms total with a detached 2-car garage. So when we first saw this, obviously, we love multifamily, and this was on a bigger lot with a detached garage. We have experience converting these garages into ADUs. So my initial thought when I saw this property is that we're just going to go in and convert the garage into an ADU, perhaps add some square footage, like new foundations, stick build, and we'll attach it to the garage, quote unquote ADU, and just build ADU out of that. However, after looking at it further, we're gonna show you the plans, and you can see we're going to build 2 ADUs. When you buy properties and we do real estate deals, not everything will go your way at all times. For example, we closed on this property and we submitted paperwork, we submitted for permitting. We've done a good amount of work already. And the county, Sacramento County, by the way, oh, here's a hack. If you wanna do projects fast, buy properties in Sacramento City and not Sacramento County. Sacramento County, this is a direct slap towards you guys. You guys are like 3 months behind, super slow, horrible with communication.
2-9.
Sacramento City jurisdiction though is extremely efficient. We can go in and out entire permitting process, finish the build in 6 to 8 months, right? Now Sacramento County on the other hand, I have projects submitted to them where we still haven't gotten a response. It's been like 2 months.
2-9.
And for this particular project, we submitted a bunch of documents, everything was smooth sailing, and suddenly we get an email stating that there's some red flags on a duplex. We need to convert it into a conforming duplex before we can submit. That's entirely another story. I just want to bring that up because I want you as the investors to know, or when you're getting into investing, not everything goes by plan all the time. And more than often, something will get thrown at you from random direction and you just have to deal with it. And this is one of those situations, okay? So for this one, let's just say we get beyond it and they approve our plans for the 2 ADUs. We will build 2 ADUs. There's 2-bedroom, 1-bathroom each in the back. And the plan is to build them and then lease them out at market rate to Section 8 tenants. And we'll cash flow the property and perhaps sell this project to another investor, or we'll do some type of cash out refinance so that we can pull out the money that we have invested plus some, right? Now, let's talk about the numbers. Very important for me to go over it. It's very important for you guys to know this and to know what to expect realistically, okay? We got in the contract at $469,000. We subsequently negotiated $20,000 of seller credit. That means the seller is going to credit us $20,000 towards whatever we want at the close of escrow. We came in with $50,000 cash, okay? And the rest is all loans. We used the private money. Some people don't like private money. I love private money. And the reason being is that we can close in 10 to 15 days. We can be very aggressive with our offers. I work with these guys and this company a lot. So it's just very hassle-free, okay? And because we have a good amount of experience working with renovation and small-scale developments, we can't finish this project in about like a year, year and a half at most. So our holding time is not the longest in the world, right? And so we can calculate exactly how much money we're going to make using someone else's money. And yes, the interest rate is a little bit higher. That's the downside. But on the upside, we close faster. We're more aggressive with our offers. They're extremely reliable. Sometimes traditional financing takes anywhere from 30 days to 60 days. They make you jump through hoops all the time. It's just not something I want to do all the time. For this project, I know we're not going to hold it long term. in this condition, meaning that we're gonna get in, we're going to add value, and then we're going to have a capital event, either cash out refi or we're going to sell the property. So for this initial phase, we're choosing to use private money, okay? And that is one of my tools that I frequently use. I don't hide from it, I actually love it. So you as an investor, you figure out what you like doing and then you invest how you want to based on your personality, all right? Now, we got in with 50K cash. I believe it's going to cost us about $350,000 total from permitting until construction is complete, okay? So meaning that total cash in for this will be around $400,000, not including debt service, okay? Debt service is what it will cost us to service the debt. That means to pay for the loan. But here's the thing. I love multifamilies because of the fact that there are renters renting the front two units. That's gonna cover all of our ongoing expenses. So only money out of our pocket is money for the build out, money for permitting, and the initial deposit. Does that make sense? So right now, the front two duplexes, one unit is being rented out for $1,970. The other unit is being rented out for $1,272. The one that's $1,272 is way below market because they're the same units, the 1970 and the 1272. So we have the option to increase that 1272 to 1900 if we wanted to. But I don't like doing that initially. I just kind of like the tenants just kicking it there, just hanging out until we're done with all of the developments, until we're done with the build out. And of course, we're gonna give them notice ahead of time, like, hey, we are, you know, renovating the property. Our intention is to sell. We don't try to hide it from the tenants. We let them know up front. So this gives them time to prepare to move. So right now the rents are about $3,242 a month. It's about $38,904 a year. Once we're done with the build outs, we'll have four units instead of two. So this four units, total rent and market, okay? The front two units will get us about $2,200 a unit at least. So that's $4,400 for the front two, right? And the back two that we're building, that's going to be at least $1,500 per unit. So pro forma at market, okay, we will be able to get about $7,400 a month, about $88,800 a year once we're done with the complete build out. And here's the thing, if this was a single family home, the value of the single family home will largely be dependent upon market conditions, right? But multifamily, the value is largely determined by gross rents because who buys these properties? Investors buy them. How do investors do the math? They do the math based on a gross rent multiplier, all right? So if this property is worth is making $88,800 a year, it's very easy to derive the value by multiplying the $88,800 a year by 10, okay? This is in not even a very good neighborhood. This is in like lower income neighborhood. So the idea here is that you can times the gross annual rent by a multiple of 10, or a multiple of 12, that's the range of the value of your investment assets, okay? So if you times by 10, the property will be worth $888,000. If you multiply the gross rent by 12, the property is worth $1,065,600, right? So if it's worth $888,000 because we put an X10 multiplier on that, we will make about $88,000 net. If we put a 12 multiplier on that, we will make about $250,000, $265,000 net on that, okay? Now, that's probably the range in between $88,000 to $265,000. I would bet, though, it will be closer or above the $1 million mark due to the fact that we're gonna renovate the bottom unit, we're gonna build two brand new ADUs in the back. And I know our craftsmanship, the people that we sub to, the contractors we hire, they do very good quality work. The idea here is that, look, we get in, we build the ADUs, we rent them out to Section 8, right? And then we now have a stabilized investment asset that we now can either do a cash out refi on, or we can go ahead and sell it to another set of investors, okay? So the profit range here is, again, $88,000 to $265,000. We're probably floating between, you know, $150,000 to $250,000. That's what I'm guessing. And then we'll check back in with you guys once we're done. This project should take us about 6 months to a year. If the county actually, you know, do their jobs and do it in an efficient manner, I don't see that happening anytime soon, but you know, if they do, we'll finish about 6 months or so. If not, it's about a year, maybe a year and a half. We'll see. We'll get back to you guys. And hopefully we get to finish very soon. And hopefully we get to report back to you guys with some, you know, great results.
As you guys can see behind me, we're in front of this big blue house. All right. On paper, this is 3-bedroom, 1-bathroom each unit. There are 2 units. However, when we went inside, you guys will see in the B-rolls that it's actually 4-bedroom, 1-bath per unit. Okay, there's an upstairs unit and then there's a downstairs unit. And of course, we're getting this at a very good price. And the cool thing about this property is that it also has a detached 2-car garage, which we have the option to convert that into an ADU. And this is on a really big lot. Okay, so once you go back there, we're gonna go to the backyard. So you'll see this entire lot goes all the way back. And then that will give us room to build additional units in the back. So either that's going to be addition, meaning that we're just adding on to this unit, or it could just be ADU. Maybe we're gonna expand that and build a very big unit in the back. We don't know what we're gonna do yet until we close on the property, and then we have engineers take a look at it to see what type of plans we can draw up and also what the city will approve. So that's all, you know, it's a process, but the first thing we need to do is we need to lock this down. And currently we're already in contract, and you guys can see, I don't know if you see him, but the realtor Mike, he's actually on the phone on Zoom call with the inspector right now because they're not currently doing site visits. And then so they're requesting for the realtors to come with their phones and then actually do the walkthrough for them while they're on video feed, all right? So just take a look. So if you look, it goes all the way to the back. It's a lot of room that we can build on. This is like, this could be his own space, essentially. Yeah, so this could be his own ADU by itself, and it will have his own private backyard, or we can even expand on this building and make it perhaps into a 3-bedroom, 2-bath. We don't know yet, we'll see. Once we close on it, we'll figure it out. But right now, it's our priority to close on this first because it's a really good deal. In order to make money, you have to seize these opportunities first, and that's what we're doing here right now.
He's on his way. You need to come in here now?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you. Video chat. The inspector's on the camera.
Don't send him. That's what I'm saying. What are you guys gonna take pictures of?
The inside of the rooms.
Of my personal stuff is what I'm saying.
No.
Thank you guys so much for your time. Hopefully you learned something new here. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments. Stay tuned and follow our progress. All right, see you next episode.